Well, welcome to the Schoolhouse Arts and History Center. We're back here again, Bill, but today is what? We have a special ceremony today going on.
We do, Andy. It's actually our grand opening.
Wow.
And it's in conjunction with the centennial of the 1917 edition and also the 90th anniversary of the Bethel Park Volunteer Fire Company.
Well, it's going to be a great show. It's going to be a great day. And you've been working, what, almost 2 years coming up? Almost
no,
2 years
no,
on
no.
this?
No, it's only been a little over a year.
Wow.
14 months.
Wow. A few more gray hairs maybe?
Lot more. But it's just been such a rewarding experience, and we've come so far.
Yeah.
And we're just going to continue to expand upon what we've done, and we've got great plans for the building.
Well, I'm looking forward to the day. It's going to be a lot
Good.
Of fun. The weather's holding up nicely. We got a lot of dignitaries coming, and I'm sure we have
yep.
a lot of residents of Bethel Park and the surrounding community come to see just where we are on this building. It's a gorgeous building.
And I hear that there are a few surprises
Ooh.
That we today. So
stay tuned,
yeah,
stay
absolutely.
Tuned. All right, stay tuned, folks. We got a lot planned for today. We're here with the Metropolitan Window family, the Smootsers. So we just want to thank you for being part of this festive day here. And what do you think of the nice sign there that says Historical Landmark?
It's a great day for Bethel Park, and we were happy to be part of it.
So seeing all these windows next to that plaque, is that meaningful to you at all?
Oh, absolutely. It makes the building look like it did back in the early 1900s. And they look nice, and I hope they enjoy it for years to come.
Okay, Maggie?
Oh, it looks great. Looks wonderful. We're very honored to be part of this history.
Yeah, it's a great opportunity to be a part of this revitalization of this whole landmark, and to see the transition from the original windows to what it is now, it's fantastic.
Okay, your turn.
And I'm just echoing what they've said. I've not been here myself, so I'm actually excited to see what they've done inside.
Well, thank you for helping to restore our building here in Bethel Park.
You.
All right, and here we are with a representative from the Pittsburgh History and Landmark. So what do you think of your plaque on our building?
Oh, it's fabulous to have the community come together and really respect the past, especially our architectural past, and to be able to preserve it for the future and to go along with the history of this great community.
Thank you, and thank you for the plaque.
Thank you.
Ron, we're here in front of this great building. It's part of Bethel Park. You're our judge here in Bethel Park. What does it mean to be here in Bethel Park and be part of this organization and this community?
Oh, it's an immense, heartfelt care with regard to what Bethel Park has, what we can do as a community, and this center, this old schoolhouse, now this landmark, presents itself for all the people and all the hard work as a history and a place where people can gather and do great things. And I'm so proud to be part of Bethel and be part of this community. There's so many wonderful people. So many people work so hard to put this together. And many of them obviously were acknowledged here today. I'm filled with pride, and I love history, as you know. And this is something that will live on and teach children and people about our community and about the history of it. And it'll bring about art. It'll bring about culture. It's something that I don't want to say was missing, but it's just another block in the foundation that makes Bethel so great.
It's well said. Thank you. All right, Sue. We're inside the building now, and we just want to thank you for being part of this wonderful building, and wanted you to say a few words to Bethel Park for what it means to be part of the this building and the Historical Society and being here today.
Thank you. Well, first of all, I just want to say It's just wonderful because history really does give us our roots. And we're in this classroom. This is my classroom that I was in sixth grade. So I remember my teacher. Helps you remember your friends, your family. It really gives you the values that you treasure so dearly. And I remember starting every day with prayer. I remember the Pledge of Allegiance and scriptures. And those are fond memories. There are values that we hold to. And I also remember that in this room, I was taking a history test, and our teacher, someone came in the room and whispered to Miss Pond, "The president has been shot." And she turned pale. She told us, "Turn your papers over. We're done with the test." And she took us into the parking lot where she had a convertible, and she turned on the radio, and we listened to the tragic news that John F. Kennedy was shot. So there you have history.
Well, this room, does it look anything like what it did when you went to class here?
Yes, it does. Yes, it does. So what happened was I was part of the bumper crop of kids after World War II, and there were so many that they had to take four classrooms of sixth graders from different schools. Like I would have gone to Memorial School, and they put us here. So that was cool. We were in our own school with just sixth graders, but then it was real scary. We had to go over the junior high for lunch, and those were the big seventh and eighth graders. And my dad also went to school here, too. So my father's 96. He went to school on Irishtown Road, the beginning of elementary. So I think this was junior high, and then where the community center, that was a senior high. So yeah, It's just wonderful to be here today, and it's a testimony to the volunteerism, really. I mean, citizens bought windows, we've gotten tons of donations, lots of hard work, and it's just a wonderful, exciting day. So thank you for interviewing me.
Well, thank you for being part of today and for being part of restoring this building. I know it means a lot to us, the residents of Bethel Park, and it's a fun place to be and visit.
And people to come here because we have a lot of mining remnants. You know, we have lunch boxes and lanterns and pictures. We have a great collection of yearbooks. So people should come and see what it was like to go to school here 100 years ago and 50 years ago. So it's a good thing. Thank you, Andy.
Yep. So the Schoolhouse Arts and History Center is open. So please stop by and take a look.
Come and visit.
All right, Mrs. Canals, thank you for taking time to talk to us. We're just doing a show about the restoration of this building, and we wanted to thank the Canals family for what you've done. And what does it mean for you to actually be standing in this room now?
Actually, I didn't expect it to look like this.
Okay.
So I'm really surprised and pleased.
Okay.
So I think it's great.
Well, it's nice that your family helps contribute to Bethel Park in helping us restore this building.
Well, my husband went to first grade here, I guess from 1 to 6, whatever they had at that time. So this is where he started.
Yeah.
His family have been here for over 100 years, so they've been long-time residents.
Well, we're happy to have them as residents and lucky to have you as a resident here at Bethel Park. So thank you for taking the time, and thank you for sharing your little stories.
Thank you.
All right, Robert, thank you for being here in Bethel Park, part of the restoration here of this gorgeous Schoolhouse Art and History Center. And what does it mean, since you're from the Heinz History Center, to be out here in Bethel Park and to see one of the buildings that we're doing?
This is actually the first time that I've been here to this exact building and location. And as I said in my opening remarks, the Bethel Park Historical Society is a History Center Affiliates Program member. They're one of about 400 sites that we help across the tri-state area become better at what they do. And under the leadership of Bill Haberther and others, it's just a wonderful occasion to see all of his work and the work of others come together.
Well, does this go hand in hand with the History Center down in Pittsburgh then?
Most definitely. What I always like to say is that the History Center and its mission is to present American history with a Western Pennsylvania connection. But being a native Pittsburgher, as I'm sure you are and many of us are, there's so much history out in our region that the History Center, as large as we are cannot tell each and every story. And so we truly rely on historical societies in Bethel Park, in Shaler, in North Allegheny, in Denora to really take charge of their local history.
Well, I think we're pretty proud to say we're associated with your organization. So thank you for coming out to Bethel Park.
Thank you. I'm glad to be out here in the South Hills from the North Hills. And as I said, I and the Heinz History Center will continue to support the great work that Bethel Park is doing and the Bethel Park Historical Society. Glad to be here.
Thank you. John, welcome to Bethel Park TV Cable again. And we're glad to be here in this building. And can you tell us a little bit about your affiliation to this building itself that you're in?
And I'm in it now. I have a studio next door. And I've been here for many years, and I think it's one of the best things that ever happened at Bethel Park in this building, where they're renovating it, you know, thanks to Bill, who is really initially somebody's really backing him. His mother graduated from this school, and is also his father. So you see, it's a monument to them, you know. But it's a great area, and I didn't expect this turnout. But they're waking up, and I don't know how they should feel. This is an integral part of Bethel Park, and they should participate and make it work. It's a beautiful. Look at that floor. Holy cow.
Gorgeous, isn't it?
It's just, they had the right craftsmen to do it all, and I'm just overjoyed. Then they're going to put air conditioning in, which is nice, too. You know, that's very nice. No, it's a place that I work, but they're still working on my studio. My studio is open, but it's all crowded, you know. And the paintings are hanging up in mine. I enjoy it.
So how many?
I'm only 92. Okay. I'm going to be 93 this month on the 29th. And I didn't go to Europe. I've been in Europe for 47 years with the school. I didn't go back this summer only because of my equilibrium. And so it may be that I'll make it back, you know, 2018. We'll see what happens, you know.
So how many years have you actually been in this building, you think?
Easy 10, maybe, because it was a shambles in the beginning.
So you've seen a lot of changes over those years you've been in the building.
Just magnificent. And Bill's keeping me in contact with what he's doing. He speaks to me a lot and informs me what's going on. And also Murphy. They got the right people behind it all, you know. Yeah. And they're not politicians. They're genuine people. They know how to work. They know how to get people. They put in 7 windows in my studio. Each one was $500.
Yep.
You know, that's just, who are you now again?
My name is Andy.
Andy. Yep. Are you connected with them at all? No?
Just friends. We like to help them out.
Good.
We're all friends in this town.
Okay, very good. Yep. It's a delight. In Italy, you know, they renovate everything. They don't tear anything down. This was ready to be torn down. And then somebody, I think it might have been Anderson, one of the teachers, who backed it and they saved it. This is what should happen. In Italy, from the Alps all the way down to Sicily, there's always something to renovate because it's thousands of years old. It's just great. So if this has to be initially understood by the people of this town, you know, and by others outside, that this is a historical place. Now, if they had seen the floor before, now and see it now, this is fantastic. Just lovely. So I applaud everybody and all those who really contributed a great deal and who gave of themselves, you know. I couldn't give too much of myself. I just gave them the painting thing.
Well, that's important, too.
Yes. No, it's lovely.
All right, Tim, what a great day. Your grand reopening of this fabulous building here in Bethel Park. And, you know, as a resident of Bethel Park, what does this mean to you?
It really means a lot. I think more than anything, it's the building, but it's the people that have got involved and have come out and donated, not only financially, but also things, memorabilia from their past. And it's truly been it's developed into the culture center of the community. I think people are thriving on that.
I have to think, though, with all your years of public service here in Bethel Park, you're probably meeting a whole batch of different people that you've never come in contact before.
No, absolutely. It's the people, too. The people you meet, the stories they tell, that they either live here or they were from here and come back and are reminiscing. So it's been just a great thing for the community and for the Historical Society.
Well, did you always have a love for history?
I would say a little bit. I said my involvement really started that we were looking at the building, quite frankly, and I thought we needed to make a decision on either to renovate it and get it back up to where it used to be, or we needed to take another course because just not a lot of things going on down here at the time.
Well, that was a big decision to make, though.
Yeah, it was. It really was. We had our first step is we had an architect come in and evaluate the building to make sure the building was structurally sound, and that was really the basis for everything we've done.
Okay. But, well, I know as being part of the community, you know, we applaud you on the direction that you went and, you know, getting the Historical Society really to the place they are today.
No, it's been great. I think we have 80-plus members. Not all are active. A lot of them participate. But when you need something, they come out. Over the last week, we've been doing a lot of cleaning and getting ready. We probably had 40 members over the course of the week come out and get involved and help us get the building ready.
And it's really not just residents, though. You've had a lot of businesses, local and outside of Bethel Park, that have really embraced this project.
No, certainly. Actually, True Value, Andy, has been, thank you very much for your donations. Yes, the windows, a lot of in-kind work was done, and it's been a challenge, but people are really stepping up and willing to help us. Once they come in here and see the building, probably is the biggest selling tool we have.
Well, it has to put a smile on your face, though.
No, it really does. I've worked on a lot of projects in my 20-plus years, and honestly, this is the most fulfilling. The community's really stepped up and come out and really helped us. So it's been really a tremendous last 18 months.
Okay. And what do you see in the next 18 months?
Well, hopefully we're going to see the building, the first floor, hopefully within the next month. The heating and air conditioning will be installed. If all goes well, we look to put a new roof on next year. We're waiting for a couple potential grants to hear from that. But we're going to continue with, we're selling pavers. We need to generate money. There's a lot of things we have planned that are maybe raise a couple hundred dollars to a couple thousand. But we need to raise the money to make the building self-sustaining.
Well, we appreciate your time here. And you know, as a resident of Bethel Park, I appreciate your involvement with this Schoolhouse Arts Center.
Thank you very much.
Yep. Bill, gorgeous plaque. What does it do to you to see the plaque finally on the building?
You know, Andy, it's so heartwarming. It was one of those moments where it all came to fruition when we got the plaque from the Pittsburgh History and Landmarks Foundation. And although this building was designated a historic landmark back in 1990, it wasn't until this year that we actually purchased the plaque, which the timing actually is all that more sweet because it's the centennial of the addition. So we just had our open house. It went beautifully. And it just, as you can see, from your last visit, your first visit, we've dramatically changed the building.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Big changes.
And you know, the important thing is with the new windows, people that haven't stopped and been in the building yet, as they drive by and they actually see that the windows have been replaced, they see life in the building, and they know that it's no longer going to be torn down, that it's a viable entity, and they want to find out more information about what's coming along. And we have gotten so much positive feedback, an increase in membership, an increase in donations, an increase in checks. So it can't get any better.
Well, if you could look back 5 years ago, because I think you were still in New York.
I was still in New
York. You know, did you ever think that you would be here standing on the steps in front of this, you know, running an organization like the Bethel Park Historical Society?
Well, I'm just the secretary and a board member. And so, Tim Mowry is our president, and Susie Dolinar is our treasurer, and we have, five other people that are board members. And it's just such an incredible group of people. And we're doing a lot of physical work, but we don't mind it because we all have such great fun doing everything that we're doing here. It's just literally, we knew that we were planning this open house, and 2 days ago, a construction company decides that they have some free time and they milled the front driveway. So we took off like an inch and a half of asphalt, and we were finally down to the Red Dog. So it's just, that's the first step in the preparation for our Pave the Way campaign. How'd you like that segue into our next, our capital campaign? So hopefully, we'll be able to restore that with brick pavers. But it's such an incredible day. It's just, you know, we're standing on these steps that are beautifully decorated by our good friend Jim Jenkins from Jim Jenkins Lawn and Garden Center. His wife Lisa came the other day and brought all these wonderful fall decorations for us, so we certainly appreciate it.
It's
you know, people want to give back. They want to do what they can, whatever way they can. So
what's next?
Next, driveway. The HVAC people are in as we speak, installing the air conditioning and heating system. So we've got some 4 pads out back for the condensers. Okay. There's some acorns, they call them, some vent holes along the side of the building. So we'll finish that. And then we're just going to continue classroom by classroom. We have a couple of tenants that won't be coming back next year. So once their lease is up at the end of the year, we'll get into those rooms and start renovating. I have several other people that are looking forward to coming into the building, which is wonderful. There's a dance troupe that wants to come in, which is exciting. It's another form of the arts. Mm-hmm. It's just more people. And as you and I have talked about in the past, Andy, it's all about getting people into the building. And once they see the beauty and what we're trying to achieve here, they want to get involved.
Well, telling the residents of Bethel Park who watch us and their surrounding community, this isn't just Bethel Park.
Right.
How do they reach you? Are there set hours that they could come and visit the building yet?
Right.
Or how far along are you actually be open for business every day?
We're not as of yet, because we just don't have the volunteers to sit here and keep the building open. But we do have work nights on Tuesdays and Thursday evenings from about 6 to 8, and then all day Saturday from about 9 o'clock to 2. So if people are in the area, they can stop by at any of those 3 times, or they can just contact me on our through our email or our Facebook page, Bethel Park Historical Society, and say, you know, if somebody's in town and wants a special tour, we're more than happy to accommodate people.
Excellent.
So
we appreciate your time, and
my pleasure,
we appreciate everything you're doing for this, the Schoolhouse Art and History Center.
You got it.
Thank you.
Thanks, Andy. Good to see you again.
Yep.
Okay, so welcome. We've got so much going on today, but I just wanted to take a few minutes and point out one of our little Geraldo Rivera moments. We've talked about this on prior shows. It's actually the entryway to the girls' bathroom, which has been boarded over for over 50 years. And the reason we broke through the wall is because the HVAC system is being installed and the guys needed to access the bathroom to get all the plumbing in. So if Dave will pan downstairs, you can actually see it's in pretty good shape, the girls' bathroom, except the hallway at the bottom of the steps, the stair is actually, the floor has actually collapsed a little bit. But nothing that can't be fixed, as we've learned. But in essence, what we're going to do is, once we're at the point that we can get down there and work on the girls' bathroom, we're going to completely take down the wall and open up the stairwell. But it was exciting to be in a part of this building that hadn't been walked upon in over 50 years. Okay, we're here on the mezzanine level, and one of the reasons for this display, it's the 50th anniversary of the band festivities, which happened yesterday, and also the 60th anniversary of the Bethettes. So we wanted to do a display to honor both of those entities. So as you can see over my shoulder, we've got a 1940s majorette uniform, and we just had the baton from 1944 donated to us. And right here we have a pre-1964 band uniform, and we know it's pre-1964 because Park was added to Bethel Park in the 1964 school year. In addition, we've got some original Bethettes uniforms, which interestingly enough, over the past 60 years, they have not changed. And we also, in sort of an honorarium to Dean Streeter, who directed the band for so many years, his daughter Lynn Streeter Dunbar had donated a collage that the kids had put together for Mr. Streeter when he retired. In another room that we're going to go into, we have also, Lynn gave us his chalkboard that he used to do all the formations for the drill teams for the band. So we're very excited to receive all these wonderful items to the Bethel Park Historical Society. So actually, we're standing in what we commonly refer to as the tin ceiling room. This room hasn't been restored yet. It was actually underwritten underwritten by the Bethel Park Community Foundation. So what we're standing next to, in honor of the 90th birthday of the Bethel Park Volunteer Fire Company, we're standing next to George Pokerjack's uniform. His son Luke had donated it back to us. And on the floor, we've got a 1927 fire extinguisher and also some other memorabilia from the fire department. So we're sitting in the William F. Murdoch classroom, and although the space is 95% finished, we still need to refinish the floors, and then this room will be completed. But what's really fun about this room is during this open house, we had a lot of children in, and they just are so mesmerized with being able to sit in a classroom and at one of these old-fashioned desks. So even though today is the open house, and we have a lot of activity going on, we still have plenty of work to do. So I encourage people that want to get involved with the Bethel Park Historical Society to contact us either on our Facebook page, Bethel Park Historical Society, or our email at historicalsocietybp@gmail.com to just send me a note and come and join the society, get involved with the renovation project. We plan on doing a lot of lecture series here in the future, renting out the space as a venue for whether it be a high school reunion. These are all things that we have planned to truly make this a cultural center for the community. So in future shows, we'll be able to highlight some of the other areas that we're doing. We have a couple of tenants that will be leaving the building, and as soon as that happens, we'll be in redoing some work in their rooms and seeing who we can get involved in that space on a going forward basis.
Hello, how are you, buddy? Did you guys get to ride on a fire truck?
Yes.
Oh man, that's the best thing. How about a cookie? Cookies, that's the best thing. How about hot dogs? Hot dogs are the only way I like dogs. Hey, Sparky, back off. Keep walking. That's right. Sparky, the fire dog over there.
Bye.
Bye. I'd wave if I could.
We're very excited to partner with our friends at Columbia Gas. I have Lee right there, guys.
I was just going to update my bus. Now this will give me incentive to go down to Edie's True Value Hardware and buy a few more.
Hi there, I'm John. I'm with the Beth Park Volunteer Fire Company. I'm a firefighter hazmat technician with the fire company, and I'm also a member of the Allegheny County hazmat team. Today, here with the Allegheny County hazmat truck, I'm going to show off a little bit of equipment that we use to be able to detect hazardous materials. One of the things that we use that is a hazard to us is called radiation. A tool that we have is the Allegheny Ludlum Meter. The Allegheny Ludlum Meter is used to detect any radiation in contamination. So what we can do is we can survey an object for radiation. When we hear the beeps, that tells us there's something going on. As we find radiation, it beeps a lot more. So let's just go ahead and check, and we found that there was more radiation at that test source. Some of the other equipment that we use, because we have to protect ourselves against all of the different hazards that we have. So just like with fire, we have SCBA breathing air that we wear in our hazmat suits that when we go down into a hazardous atmosphere. But sometimes we're dealing with things that are really cold. So just like when we are wearing our mittens when we're going sled riding or when it's cold in the summer, we wear mittens to deal with really cold things. The problem with that is it makes it hard for us to actually be able to turn valves and things like that. So I have a hard hat here, and as we see, it's not the easiest thing working with these gloves. Normally you're gonna be turning like a valve or a switch, but sometimes you have to try to work well with your hands when they get really hot in your nice warm mittens. And then finally, one of the last things I'll have you take a look at. Just like your vacuum cleaner at home, this is a special vacuum that we have here on the hazmat truck. It's known as a HEPA vac. So what it does is we use it to clean up any powders or metals or dusts that are causing a problem. But the difference is, it doesn't, like your vacuum, it blows air through it and the air comes out. This filters it, so that way anything that we're picking up, like mercury or aluminum, it stays all inside the vacuum and keeps everyone safe.
The whole point is, whenever we come to the firehouse, we have to get dressed as quickly as possible so we can get onto the fire truck. Okay? So, we're going to try to do this in 70 seconds. Alright?
He has his shoes on already.
So you ready? You ready to count?
Ready, set, go. like that bottle.
The which one? Oh, that's hand sanitizer. So, ready? Watch this. And then you rub it all, so it's like, you know when you use the push-down ones? It's the same thing. So now my hands are clean. So if you touch something dirty and you don't want to... But we wear gloves, so I've got some in my pocket here. So we wear gloves and we do stuff to keep us clean and to keep you guys clean. And we don't pass germs, right? And like I have the mask I put on earlier, we have masks too. So we're all about clean. We use alcohol to clean you, like if we suck you with a needle. Like you probably had a little finger prick when you were in the ambulance, right? When you're, with diabetes. And an IV. So it's like, needles aren't fun, but as long as we keep everything clean, we won't do any harm, okay? And they make you better. It does look like whipped cream. I wouldn't eat it, though. I don't think you'd want to eat that. That's
the happiest part of my day here is that Dave Cable is not behind the camera. So that makes me really, really excited to be on BPTV without Dave Cable screwing it up. But other than that, what a wonderful day we're having here at the Bethel Park Volunteer Fire Company Open House. 90 years that this organization has been part of Bethel Park, and we are lucky to have them in our community. But I enjoy coming out to these just to be meeting all the residents of Bethel Park. We've had a great crowd today, lots of families, lots of kids, and I'm here just showing lots of new products, whether it's from the Hydro Block to snap lights to smoke alarms to CO detectors, fire extinguishers, new flashlights, all sorts of home safety products that you can have in your house. So I appreciate you watching. I'm glad the families have come out in droves here to the Bethel Park Volunteer Company Fire Department Open House in 90 years. Can you believe they've been here for 90 years? So thanks for watching BPTV.